Yo, what's up everybody? It's BDL44 coming at you with another video. I want to talk a little Trailblazers. I don't follow the team like I follow my Lakers, so you're not going to get that type of commentary here in regards to the Blazers. But I did want to kind of touch in on what I see and maybe some things that they can work on. They had Chauncey Billups' introductory presser. I didn't get a chance to see it just yet, but that kind of stemmed the conversation when I realized that that was what's going on. It's, what is Chauncey going to need to succeed? What is it going to take to keep Dame there? What, you know, that kind of thing. So I just want to kind of talk about the Blazers. So the first thing that I kind of want to take a look at in regards to that team is the fact that they do have Dame Lillard. You start this conversation with Dame and you end this conversation with Dame. If he's on some Giannis Antetokounmpo, then it works. But if he's on some Anthony Davis, then obviously you need to make moves to get him out of there. The Portland Trailblazers are starting fresh. They have a brand new coach for the first time in about 7-8 years. They have a few players that I think have been there a little longer than probably they would like, and they're going to move on from those guys this offseason, I believe. Yusef Nurkic is a guy I don't see coming back. CJ McCollum's been rumored to be traded, and there's a lot of guys in his level that are on the trade block, so it's reasonable to think that he could move, and so on and so forth. They had some issues. Derrick Jones Jr. has not panned out for them. He's not turning to the wing defender, swing man that they were hoping he would. So I'm pretty sure they're going to move on from him. It's just a lot of players on that team. You know, you look around and you say, okay, they had Collins. They picked up the Collins kid, and he hasn't played in like 3 years. I mean, ever since he was drafted, he was hurt. So maybe there's some something there they can work with. Maybe he can kind of find his way off of that team and get a fresh start somewhere else where he can show why he was a lottery pick, or at the very least show that he's a role player in this league, because I just don't think he's had a chance to. He literally been hurt his whole career. It's crazy. But I have seen some things out of him in the distant past that let me understand that he's got some stuff, and he's kind of lost in Portland like what happens to several other players that just kind of don't get a chance to get healthy to start their careers. So he's a guy that I look at as a guy of volatile talent, as I usually label him. You just don't know what he's going to get, but someday he's going to be put in the game and he's going to do some things, and you're going to be like, I get it. He's one of those. So when it comes to the Portland Trailblazers, they also made a trade that I thought was a little questionable. They traded Gary Trent Jr., young shooter, of course, son of Gary Trent, player that used to play for the Toronto Raptors, and I think he played for the Rockets. I think he played for the Clippers. I don't remember the other teams that Gary played for, but you know, he comes from good stock, and he's a pure shooter. You know, his daddy was not a shooter, but this kid is. And they traded him to the Toronto Raptors in what was considered a lateral move by myself for Norman Powell, a very respectable, pure scoring bench player, sixth man of the year type guy who continues to get better every year. He's exceeded expectations for me many times over as it pertains to his development. Over the past 5 years or so, Norman Powell has just taken the role that he was given in Toronto and slowly but surely taken every opportunity he could to show that he had a more talent in his role. And he was a part of a championship team in Toronto. And they won pretty damn strong with efforts from him. So he's earned the right to have this type of cachet to be traded. For a young player like that, is basically being traded for a pick. That's pretty solid. And I think that no matter where he plays in this league, he's going to do what it is that he does. He's going to have games where he scores 25, 30 points, and he's going to play hard. And that's the type of player that he's turned into. Look, you love having him. I don't think he's a bad acquisition for Portland, but it's about who you traded to get him. And I just feel like the younger player who also does all the things that he does and probably has more upside than him, was traded in a deal that is basically a win-now deal, because Norm Powell's obviously a win-now player. So you traded away a project that was doing all the stuff that Norm does, and I just did not like that move at all, because it didn't address what the Portland Trailblazers actually needed. The Portland Trailblazers needed shooting, yes, but not from that position, because they have guards that can shoot. They need forwards and centers that can shoot, to be honest with you. They need unicorns. They need somebody like Kristaps Porzingis, to be honest, who can play the four spot, stretch the floor, give Dame another offensive threat to keep the defense honest, keep people off of clogging him and collapsing on him. And also, it allowed him a bit more versatility because, to be honest with you, the Portland Trailblazers have had a long-standing non-shooting center situation for, and it's just going to continue until they do something about it. The centers that they have are not lacking, but if you think about the guys that they've had in their uniform, none of them can shoot. Nurkic can't shoot. When they had Whiteside, he couldn't shoot. Who else on this team? You got Enes Kanter. He's a nice scoring player for sure. He can score like the wind, but he's not shooting threes. Who else? As I said, Collins, he can't shoot. Not that I know of. Maybe he can shoot. I don't think so, but he ain't seen him out there, so it doesn't make a difference. They had a guy named Caleb Swanigan. He's out the league. He's doing bad from what I understand. Prayers up to him. He had gained all kinds of weight in just a matter of a year. I hope he get his body right and get his mind back to basketball, because I think there's still money out here for a guy with his skill set, because guess what? He could shoot, but that didn't work out. It's just one of those things, man. Derrick Jones Jr. is not considered a big, but his three-point shooting is not where you need it to be. It's just it goes on and on. The only players that can shoot are the same players who are supposed to be setting up the players who can't shoot, and that's a bad dynamic, and it's why the Portland Trailblazers continue to lose year in, year out. You shooters need to be able to shoot. But if they're tasked with setting up players who can't shoot, you got the dynamic that only works from the inside out, and it's too traditional at this stage in the game. Dame is too much of a unicorn shooter to be playing on a traditionally old school caliber roster, and that's exactly what Portland has done. In a nutshell, the Portland Trailblazers have not caught up to the rest of the league as it pertains to finding unicorns. They need them. They need to find somebody who can do the Joel Embiid thing, who can do the Anthony Davis thing, who can do what Karl Towns does. That's what they need. They need to get away from the traditional old back to the basket, I'm staying in the paint, I can barely shoot free throws centers. That's what they need to do. That's what they need. If they could get their hands on a John Collins, you know, that kind of player, that would be amazing for them. If they can get their hands on a Pascal Siakam, that type of player would be amazing for them. That's where my head is as it pertains to the Portland Trailblazers. They have the shooting. They just don't have it where they need it. You don't need your shooting guard and your point guard to be your best shooters. I'm sorry. I know that sounds crazy because traditionally you do. But now I would prefer my best shooters to be in the 4 spot and the 3 spot. I want those guys to be able to shoot because they create opportunities for the guys who are ball handlers to have more of an option for themselves. Now they don't have the paint clog, so they can drive more. Now they can have better opportunities for spacing. Now they have opportunities to where they don't have the defense collapsing on them, because the bigs can stretch the floor. Simple as that. So I think that's the dynamic that Portland is missing dramatically. They have all world shooters in their backcourt, but their front court is from the 1980s, and that is it. That's the bottom line. To go along with that, they could definitely use a Brandon Ingram type. They could definitely use someone with some length at the 3 spot who could shoot a 3, create for himself, and just do a whole lot of stuff. Anybody that can do what Brandon Ingram, Jason Tatum, these are extreme names, obviously. You can't get a hold of these guys, but what you want is their skill set. You want somebody that does what they do. You need, it doesn't even have to be anybody that super talented. I'm thinking about a guy like Royce O'Neal would be great for Portland. I'm thinking of players like that. God, man, my mind is like a Christian Wood. Obviously, he's stuck in Houston. He's going to be there. They're going to pay him. But that type of player, you give Portland one of those, suddenly Dame has a lot more to work with. I really do think Portland should go after Pascal Siakam. I hear he's on the move. That's the type of guy I think Dame could really work with. He isn't the most consistent player, but when he's right, boy, is he a hell of a assistant scoring punch. He's already proven he can help a championship caliber team being the second guy or the third guy. That's what Portland needs. Go after Pascal. That's what I've come to terms with. I think he's on the move. I think he's a doable piece to receive. They'll probably have to give up CJ, which I in theory you don't want to do. I think I'd rather have CJ, but if I'm Portland, I would rather not. And the reason why is because CJ and Dame can't defend. Respect to those guys. I think the world of them, but they're not defenders. They're at a disadvantage every night when they go up against very, very talented guards. So what you need is somebody who can step in and defend. who can step in and just be bigger, longer, stronger, and faster than the guards that they're forced to guard. At that two spot, that three spot, like I said, a Brandon Ingram would be perfect for Portland because he can score and he can defend and he has length and he can get in passing lanes and do all that Trevor Ariza stuff that Portland loves. So that's where my head is with Portland, man. They have the makings of being able to make moves. They have a little more flexibility than some because of CJ and his value in this league. But they got to find more talent. They have to find more talent in the four spot. They got to find more talent in the five spot. Four, five, and three. They got to find more talent. And if they can improve on two and get a defensive player in place of CJ, you do that too. So basically, in short, Portland needs everything. Portland needs everything. And if I'm Dame, I recognize that. So if I want to give them another season to try to see if they can put themselves on the trajectory to kind of turn this thing around fast, maybe they can get a piece or two, they're not going to be able to turn it all the way around in one season. But, you know, if a guy really wants to be there, he doesn't need to see them turn it around overnight. He just needs to believe they can turn it around soon enough for him to feel good about it, staying there. That's it. And Portland is in a position where I think they can do that. Their GM is saying the right things. Chauncey Billups is coming in with the right attitude. I heard there's some friction there. I don't think Dame is really excited about Chauncey coming in. I think Dame should let that shit go. If I'm being completely blunt, let that shit go. Chauncey Billups is somebody that's 10 times more relatable to what it is you are trying to do than the coach that you've had for the last 7 years. I know change is not fun. When you have a coach that you believe in, that believes in you, and that has coached you all the way through your success, you definitely want to see him succeed, and you could care less if he's the best guy for the job. You just want your family close, so I get it. If he's been there that long, chances are Dame sees him as family, because if he didn't want him there, he'd be gone already. That's the reality of the situation in Portland. So I don't think he was happy his coach was getting fired, and I don't really think it matters who he brings in, but Chauncey Billups was the right type of guy. He was the right type of guy, and you need to give him a chance. Give him a chance to get the hell out of there. That's what I'll say. And I say that respectfully because I like Dame and I don't think Dame's a shitty guy. But what I don't want to see happen is what happened to the coach of the Rockets at the beginning of the season last year. That was some bullshit. And it wasn't James Harden's fault because I know he needed to get up out of there. I felt James Harden. You got to do what you got to do to leave. Sometimes it's collateral damage. It just sucks. But if we can avoid that repeating itself and giving Chauncey Billups the type of start that Silas got with a team with a star that wants to leave and a bunch of pieces that aren't sure what their roles are because of it, that's a wrong way to start Chauncey's career. I don't want to see him start his career the same way Silas did. And I point more so at the organization than Dame, because Dame's got to do what's right for Dame. And if he's pushing himself out of Portland, damn it, that's what you got to do. But the organization needs to settle that. They need to make sure that Dame's situation is settled. If he's staying, he's staying. If he's out, make a move. Because what you don't want to do, if you care, because some organizations could care less, is start Chauncey Billups' career off the wrong way. And he's a rookie coach, so that's he doesn't deserve that. He don't deserve that. So if you're on board, Dame, let's do this. Stay with Portland, resign, and give them their opportunity. If not, for the sake of the new coach, if there's friction and you don't want to play for him, straighten that shit out. Let them know you want to get up out of there and give him the courtesy of not having to go through what Paul Silas did. Period. That's how I feel. So that's also what I want to say. And I think Dame really wants to be in Portland. He's more like Giannis than he is like AD or like Harden. He is. He wants to do it there. He believes in himself to that degree. And the question is he going to psych himself into believing in the franchise that much? Because those are two different things. You can believe in yourself. But if you believe in yourself in the way that you do, then you should know that you can do it anywhere. You know what I mean? So there's two sides of that coin. At the end of the day, it's up to Dame. But one thing's for certain, he has yet to make a conference finals with the Portland Trailblazers. Or the finals, rather. I don't know if they've been to the conference finals. I don't think they have. But they have definitely not been to a final yet. We know he's the most clutch player in the game. He is. He's the guy. He has to get an opportunity here. If it ain't him, then it's KD, respectfully. But for me, when I think about end of the game, who's taking a shot right now in this era today, it's Dame. And because of it, he should have a ring or two already. So, for me, I want to see him leave Portland. Period. I think he should get the hell out of there, personally. And I've said that a million times, because I don't believe in Portland. But it's not about what I believe in. It's about him believing in the moves that they're making now, and that's what it's about. Does he believe? So we'll see. Anyway, my name is BDF44. I think I said all I need to say. If I left anybody out in regards to the Portland Trailblazers, again, I ain't a Portland fan. I'm a Laker fan. So there's that. Thank you guys for watching. Peace.